Taskade is touted as an AI-powered project management software, and in today's video, we're going to give you our review of Taskade, diving into some of the pros, cons, and also who it's most suitable for. So welcome, my name is Francesco D'Alessio, and if you are interested in finding any productivity tool, you can jump over on Toolfinder. You'll find it linked below, and it's the best way to find and discover productivity tools, and ones for teams as well. So Taskade, it's really changed since last time we checked it out. It's really focusing much more on AI-powered abilities, and that means a lot in today's world. It means lots of different things in today's world, but today we're going to really unpack some of the pros and cons of it, and also talk about who it's best for. So let's start with the pros, the positives to begin with. First of all, Taskade is available on a range of different devices. It's actually available on pretty much all of the major ones, including Linux, and it has extensions for the browser too, which makes it much far-reaching. And this application's a strange one because it's packaged up as a project management application, but it's not only suitable for project management, it's small teams. It's really designed for individuals as well to use it. Some people use it as a bullet journal, some people use it as a task list, but others can use it in a small to medium-sized team to manage projects. Now, one of the things that really makes Taskade special is the viewing options. You get a range of different project views like list, action, and you can even have other views like boards, calendar, mind map, and org charts, which is pretty amazing, and that begins in the free plan, which is, again, decent because a lot of project management software do block views from the free plan, which is really good. Now, it's also strange because Taskade has some other features when it comes to collaboration. It has features like video chat and also messaging so that you can communicate with your team in real time. It also has screen sharing and the ability to record audio and video as well, but they are locked under some of the more premium plans. But that's definitely still very strange to have in an application like this. A good thing, but also very strange. Now, one of the features people do love that sort of separated from other project management software is the much more visual nature of the mind maps and org charts. They're a fan favorite amongst people using Taskade. Now, let's take a look at the cons. This application is very potentially messy. What I mean by that is very simply, when you land on it, there's so much to dig into. There's different views, there's different workspaces, different projects, and it can get a little bit overwhelming. But once you sort of get used to the features, maybe take a few tutorials, it actually can become a lot less daunting and get yourself started in it. The other thing is, I would say it's also trickier than other applications to be able to see tasks across collective projects. They do have some features for this view, but I believe that other platforms do it much better than Taskade do. Now, obviously this isn't a con at all, but AI is a big element of the new Taskade experience, and this isn't a bad thing. There's different ways that you can use AI, and I'm not going to go through them all because they state on the website there's over 700 different uses of it. But in terms of actual practical uses, you can actually manage subtasks and generate subtasks using their task breakdown function. This is something I've seen in apps like Todoist and other experiences, and to be honest, unless you're putting a very generic task in, I don't think AI is going to be fundamentally beneficial for something like this. But there is a feature that it does play well into. There's, in mind mapping, you can actually generate ideas that spin off into their own mind map, which I think is actually a pretty decent feature here. You can also use Taskade's AI chat, which allows you to communicate with the AI and be able to get prompts and really dig into your to-do list and things like that. But it's nothing you wouldn't get in something like ChatGPT or other such alternatives. There is some good function when it comes to wording and rewriting stuff and optimizing text, which looks pretty good, and that works embedded inside a Taskade. And there are some limitations on the free plan, but when it comes to accessing it from the free plan, you do get access to it from day one, which is pretty good. Now, there's also a function called AI Agents, which they're planning to release. But AI Agents is actually going to focus on doing smaller errands and administration-based tasks for you. This, I believe, could be a decent step forward for Taskade and is the sort of thinking I think this to-do list application needs, well, project management software needs to move forward with their AI-powered promise. So, you're probably wondering, okay, Francesco, wrap it up for us. What is the experience like and how does it work? Well, Taskade's are sort of like a big application. It does a lot of different things. And that's why I think it's actually pretty decent for anyone as an individual, but also I would say anyone that's got a team up to 20. The reason why I don't recommend it past 20 is because I'm not sure entirely that it's very beneficial for that. To be honest, this application I would say is much more less structured than we see in apps like ClickUp Monday and many more because of the nature of the features. It's quite expansive in what you can do with it, and there's not as much structure as you would get in an application like those project managers I mentioned. So I wouldn't necessarily recommend it for teams larger than 20, although I have seen teams larger than 20 use Taskade. But I definitely think it's a great small project management software and has a good base as well as great pricing. The pricing for larger teams as well is much more effective as well. If you are looking to keep costs low, I believe there's $36 per 25 users per month, which is really reasonable, making about $2 per month. When you compare it to other project management softwares, that is quite considerably lower. For example, you may be charged about $8 per user per month at the minimum for some of the other project management softwares. So again, keeping it lightweight could be an option for you with Taskade in this experience. So interesting AI abilities, not necessarily fully enhanced with AI like other applications on the market, but at the same time, a really great, well-priced, small team addition, and also great for individuals as well. So Taskade is actually a great option in 2023. Let's see how it evolves into the next year. Thank you very much. I hope you enjoyed this review. If you do want to check out more productivity tools or in the hunt for them at the moment, jump over to Toolfinder and we'll see you there. So I'll see you in a future video, folks, and cheerio.